Unit 3, State Government. There are 29 states, 6 union territories and 1 national capital territory known as Delhi in India. It lays down a uniform structure for state government in Part 6 of the Constitution from Article 152 to 237, which is applicable to all the states save only the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which has a separate constitution for its government under Article 370. State government, executive, governor, chief minister, council of ministers, legislature, legislative council, upper house, legislative assembly, lower house, judiciary, high court, district courts, other courts. The constitution of Jammu and Kashmir was adopted on the 17 November 1957 and came into force on 26 January 1957. The constitution of India grants special status to Jammu and Kashmir and among Indian states, and it is the only state in India to have a separate constitution. The directive principles of the state policy and fundamental duties of the constitution are not applicable to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Right to property, which is denied as a fundamental right to rest of the India, is still guaranteed in Jammu and Kashmir. The executive. Article 154 vests the executive power of the state in the governor. Article 154(1) holds that the executive power of the state shall be vested in the governor and shall be exercised by him either directly or through officers subordinates to him in accordance with this constitution. Appointment. The governor of a state shall be appointed by the president. His usual term of office is 5 years, but he holds office during the pleasure of the president. Generally, the governor does not belong to the state where he is appointed. He can also be transferred from one state to another by the president. He can also resign any time by addressing his resignation to the president. The legislature of a state or high court has no role in the removal of a governor. A person may be appointed as a governor for any number of terms. Two conventions have been set up in the matter of appointing a person as governor of a state. He should not be a resident of the state concerned, and the state government consulted and its views are sought regarding the proposed choice. According to Article 158(3)(a), where the same person is appointed as governor of two or more states, the emoluments and allowances payable to the governor shall be allocated among the states in such proportion as the president may by order determine. Circular Commission on Centre State Relations suggested that the appointment of the governor should be made: 1. From a panel to be prepared by the state legislature, or 2. From a panel to be prepared by the state government, in effect the chief minister, or invariably with the concurrence of the state chief minister, or 3. Invariably in consultation with the state chief minister. Article 157 and Article 158 of the Constitution of India specify eligibility requirements for the post of governor. They are as follows: he should be a citizen of India, he must have completed 35 years of age, he should not be a member of parliament or of any state legislature. If he is a member of any of legislature, he automatically vacates his seat on consuming the office. He should not hold any other profitable occupation. Powers and functions of the governor. The governor is the head of the state executive and he has enormous powers. In the exercise of functions and powers, the governor, except in certain cases, is to be guided by the aid and advice of the council of ministers, headed by the chief minister under Article 163. As the executive head in the state level, the governor has following functions and power. The governor is an integral part of the state legislature, but he is not a member in the either house of the legislature. In this capacity, he enjoys the following legislative powers and functions. He has the right to summon, prorogue the state legislature and dissolve the state legislative assembly. He can address the state legislature at the commencement of the first session after each general election and the first session of each year. He can send messages to the houses of the state legislature relating to a bill pending in the legislature. He can appoint any member of the legislative assembly to preside over its proceedings when the office of both the speaker and the deputy speaker fall vacant. He can nominate one member to the state legislature assembly from the Anglo-Indian community. He nominates 1/6 of the members of the state legislative council from amongst the persons having special knowledge or practice experience in literature, science, art, cooperative movement and social service. He decides on the questions of disqualification of members of the state legislature in consultation with the election commission. Every bill passed by the state legislature will become law only after his signature. But when a bill is sent to the governor, after it is passed by the legislature, he has the options to give his assent to the bill or withhold his assent to the bill or return the bill for the reconsideration of the legislature. He has to reserve any bill passed by the state legislature which endangers the... He can promulgate ordinances when the state legislature is not in session under Article 213, but these ordinances must be approved by the legislature within 6 months. Privileges of the governor. Article 361(1) provides for the following privileges for the governor. The term of the chief minister is not fixed. He may remain as the chief minister as long as he enjoys the support of the majority of the members of the legislative assembly. He has to resign when he loses confidence of the majority in the assembly. It is understood that normally he completes 5 years term like other members in the legislative assembly. Chief Ministers of Tamil Nadu from 1947. Thiru O.P. Ramaswamy, 1947 to 1949. Thiru P.S. Kumaraswamy Raja, 1949 to 1952. Thiru C. Rajagopalachari, 1952 to 1954. Thiru K. Kamaraj, 1954 to 1963. Thiru M. Bhaktavatsalam, 1963 to 1967. Thiru C. N. Annadurai, 1967 to 1969. Thiru M. Karunanidhi, 1969 to 1976. Thiru M. G. Ramachandran, 1977 to 1987. Timothy Janaki Ramachandran, January 1988. Thiru M. Karunanidhi, 1989 to 1991. Selvi J. Jayalalitha, 1991 to 1996. Thiru M. Karunanidhi, 1996 to 2001. Selvi J. Jayalalitha, 2001. Thiru O. Panneerselvam, 2001 to 2002. Selvi J. Jayalalitha, 2002 to 2006. Thiru M. Karunanidhi, 2006 to 2011. Selvi J. Jayalalitha, 2011 to 2014. Thiru O. Panneerselvam, 2014 to 2015. Selvi J. Jayalalitha, 2015 to 2016. Thiru O. Panneerselvam, 2016 to 2017. Thiru Edappadi K. Palaniswami, 2017 to till now. Council of Ministers. The Council of Ministers are collectively responsible to the state legislature. All the members of the Council of Ministers must be the members of the state legislature. Those who are not the members at the time of their appointment must secure their seats in the legislature within a period of 6 months. All the ministers work as a team under the chief minister. As long as the chief minister is in office, the Council of Ministers will also be in power. If you know, confidence motion is passed by the Legislative Assembly, the State Ministry shall resign. Article 163 provides for a Council of Ministers to aid and advise the Governor. According to Article 163(1), there shall be a Council of Ministers with the Chief Minister at the head to aid and advise the Governor in the exercise to his functions, except in so far as he is by or under this constitution required to exercise his functions or any of them in his discretion. Other provisions relating to ministers. Article 164(1) holds that the chief minister shall be appointed by the governor and the other ministers shall be appointed by the governor on the advice of the chief minister, and the minister shall hold office during the pleasure of the governor. Article 164(1)(a) states that the total number of ministers, including the chief minister, the Council of Ministers in a state shall not exceed 15% of the total number of members of the Legislative Assembly. In Tamil Nadu, according to the strength of Legislative Assembly, 234 members, the number of ministers may be up to 36, an example 15% of 234. The Legislative Assembly, Lower House. The Legislative Assembly is a proper popular house. It is the real center of power in the state. It consists of members directly elected by the people on the basis of adult franchise. The strength of the assembly varies from state to state depending on the population. However, the maximum strength of the assembly must not exceed 500 or its minimum strength not be below 60. The term of office of the legislative assembly is 5 years. It can be dissolved even before the expiry of its term. The size of the legislative council cannot be more than 1/3 the membership of the legislative assembly, lower house of that state, but its size cannot be less than 40, except in Jammu and Kashmir where they are 36 by an act of parliament. The members draw the salary and allowances passed by the state legislature from time to time. Composition. This legislative assembly of the Tamil Nadu consists of 235 members, out of which 234 members are directly elected by the people from the constituencies on the basis of adult franchise, and one member is nominated by the governor from Anglo-Indian community. The Tamil Nadu Legislative Council was abolished by Tamil Nadu Legislative Council. Abolition Bill 1986. The Act came into force on 1st November 1986. 1/3 of the members are elected by local bodies. 1/12 of the members are elected by graduates of the universities in the state. 1/12 of the members are elected by graduate teachers. 1/3 of the members are elected by the members of the legislative assembly. 1/6 is nominated by the governor, who is eminent in the field of literary excellence, art, social services or cooperation. Article 169 deals with the creation or abolition of legislative council in a state. Article 169 holds that if the state legislative assembly passes a resolution by a majority of not less than 2/3 of the members present and voting, and by the majority of total strength of the house, requesting the parliament to create or abolish the state legislative council, then the parliament may by law provide for the abolition and creation of the legislative council. The institution of High Court originated in India in 1862 when the High Courts were set up at Calcutta, Bombay and Madras. In the course of time, each province in British India came to have its own High Court. After 1950, a High Court existing in a province became the High Court for the corresponding state. The High Courts are the highest court at state level, but being part of integrated Indian judiciary, they work under the superintendent's direction and control of the Supreme Court. The Constitution of India provides for a High Court for each state, but the 7th Amendment Act of 1956 authorized the Parliament to establish a common High Court for two or more states, or for two or more states and a union territory. For example, the states of Punjab and Haryana and the Union Territory of Chandigarh have a common High Court situated at Chandigarh. Similarly, the High Court of Guwahati is common for 7 northeast states of Assam, Nagaland, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Tripura and Arunachal Pradesh. Delhi, though not a state, has its own separate High Court. Every High Court has a Chief Justice and a number of judges. The number of judges varies from state to state. The number of judges of each High Court is determined by the President. At present, there are 25 High Courts for 29 states, including New Andhra Pradesh High Court, established in 1st January 2019 at principal seat in Amravati, and 7 Union Territories. The High Court of Madras is the one of the 3 High Courts in India established in the 3 presidency towns of Bombay, Calcutta and Madras by letters patent granted by Queen Victoria, bearing date 26 June 1862. The High Court building is the second largest judicial complex in the world after London. Appointment of the judges. Every High Court consists of a Chief Justice and such other judges as appointed by the President from time to time. Article 2. Under Article 226 of the Constitution, the High Courts are given powers of issuing rights not only for the enforcement of the fundamental rights but also for other purposes. In exercise of this power, a court may issue the same type of writs, orders or directions which the Supreme Court is empowered to issue under Article 32. Judicial review is the power of a High Court to examine the constitutionality of legislative enactments and executive orders of both the central and state governments. Though the face judicial review has nowhere been used in the Constitution. The provisions of Articles 226 and 227 explicitly confer the power of judicial review on a High Court. The 42nd Amendment Act of 1976 curtailed the judicial review power of High Court. It debarred the High Courts from considering the constitutional validity of any central law. However, the 43rd Amendment Act of 1977 restored the original position. The governor is the constitutional head of the state executive. The chief minister is appointed by the governor of the state. The council of ministers are collectively responsible to the state legislature. The legislative assembly is the real center for power in the state. At present, there are 25 high courts for 29 states and 7 union territories. The 42nd Amendment Act of 1976 curtailed the judicial review power of High Court. The 43rd Amendment Act of 1977 restored the original position.